Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in this playlist that I'm not sure what name is going to have, but it's probably going to be something like development of the brain plugin for Grasshopper. I am not sure. Anyway, what I would like to do with this initial video for the playlist is to do what I typically do when I want to tackle a new project, which is I don't start writing code right away. Because what I like to do is I like to spend some time, first of all, thinking about what do I want to do? What are the goals that I want to achieve? What are the high level goals that I would like to achieve with this project? And then I kind of like spending a little bit of time, perhaps setting a roadmap or setting like, what are the steps that I will follow to achieve those goals, right? Obviously, it always ends up happening that that roadmap gets like absolutely bent and twisted and you go sideways, etc., etc. But that's fine. At least having some kind of initial game plan is typically a good way to start a large-ish project, all right? So the first thing that I did was we sat down in together with the community here at Parametric Camp, and we kind of brainstormed and we did a little bit of literature, a little bit of background research into what could this plugin look like, what are the goals that we want to achieve, and what work has been done in this field by other people, other tools that are available out there, etc., etc. So the first thing was coming up with a name, which was not a trivial thing. We kind of settled in with the name Brain, just because Grasshopper plugins are well known for having animal names. So we didn't quite find an animal, but maybe like an organ made sense. So we did that. We also just asked ChatGPT and about possible names, and in my opinion, it gave us pretty lame names, so I think we're gonna stick to Brain for the time being. Maybe by the end of this playlist we change, I don't know. But let's call it the Brain plugin nickname, all right? And what I did was, in two live streams ago, I sat down and we spent like basically the entire live stream together with the community coming up with a set of goals, right? So if you're interested in how we actually came up with all of this, there is a link to the live stream where we recorded this in the description of this video, and perhaps a card will be popping up at some point here on the corner, right? So what we did in that live stream was we did some background research. So what has been done by other people, because we don't really want to reinvent the wheel, not interesting. We brainstorm what could be the components that we want to implement, the categories that we're going to group them in, and we kind of draft a structure of what that plugin could look like. I think this is what I wanted to go over today. This is what's most important for me. What is the philosophy, or what are the high-level goals that we would like to achieve with this plugin? For me, what this plugin is about is not about implementing machine learning things from scratch. So we're not going to be writing a plugin for linear regression, for convolutional neural networks, for like accessing, for doing TensorFlow in Grasshopper. I'm not interested in that. I'm much more interested in just like providing very simple and intuitive access to already available neural networks out there in the wild. And the ones that we are typically going to target with these plugins are those that can be accessed by some kind of API. So I'm looking specifically, for example, at OpenAI, which you can access. It's always on the cloud. You can't download it in your system, but you have to access using what's called HTTP requests. IBM Watson follows a very, very similar model. And so that's what I mean by accessing existing APIs. So the plugin is also going to be open source so that everyone can contribute, modify it, adapt it, etc., etc. We would like to make this about accessing APIs that live on the cloud. I would not want to implement components or implement systems that require some kind of complicated installation of some kind of dependencies on your system. Like you have to have like some kind of Python server running, which is running a machine learning model, or you have to be using, I don't know, Kubernetes or some virtual machine or Docker, running Docker instances, because that would basically complicate things. So I want to keep it very simple. And maybe in the future we extend into that, but not for the time being right now. Then I would like this project to be heavily educational. So it is about making very easy for access, giving access to machine learning tools for as easy as possible to newcomers. So I do strongly believe that sample files are actually a very, very useful tool to help people understand how things work. So every component or every new technique that we implement in the plugin should come with some kind of sample file that people can run. So this will be important. And it is about democratizing access to machine learning. So it's not about teaching the underlying principles of machine learning. That is a whole other bucket that we don't want to get into. And as much as we can, we would like to favor free APIs, but unfortunately, as of this recording, there aren't that many out there. Only a few examples in Hugging Face, perhaps. But we're okay with services where you have to pay for those requests. So for example, OpenAI has a credit system where you have to put your credit card and you pay like a few cents every time you request an image, etc. But what we're not going to do is that we are not going to be the ones developing those APIs and paying for those services. So we will hopefully come up with a system where people can input their own authorization tokens and they can use their tokens to pay for these services, all right? So this is a little bit of the high level goals. We may have to review this as we develop, which is totally fine, all right? Then we did some background research. We saw that there are some tools out there that have a similar philosophy, but we discussed how some of them were similar, some of them had a different angle, some of them were not open source, etc., etc. So we took a look at that, and then we basically took a look at what were the APIs that we could implement. And the main ones that we found so far, and which will be the low-hanging fruit, will be OpenAI, and those will be text completion, chat, image generation, text-to-speech, image generation. So we will probably tackle this very, very early in the development process. Then we will move on to IBM Watson, which also has a few interesting models that we can tap into. It has translations, it has natural language understanding, it has sentiment analysis, and it can also create speech from text. So you can give it a text and it can generate like a verbal representation of that. So that would be super interesting. Hugging Face was kind of a question mark here because it wasn't clear to me what the API looks like, but if we could tap into it, it would be great because they do have stable diffusion models that you can access from their API. So that would be one. And then Runway has been kind of steering away from this idea of packaging neural networks and giving them access to an API. Now it's more app-centric. So they have their own app, which is both client desktop and it's server and it's web-based. But maybe there is something that we can tap there because their models are actually pretty cool and I like them a lot. So we will take a look at those. And then if Azure, or Google like Bard, if they have any open APIs, we can probably implement those at some point, all right? We decided that the categories in Grasshopper are going to be broken down by vendor. So OpenAI, neural networks, IBM neural networks. So those are gonna be the buckets. But we also decided that we would like to implement some generics. And some generics would be something like a general HTTP GET request, a general POST HTTP POST request, in case people want to craft or they want to have very, very fine control of their request because they want to access a new model that we have not created a component for, or because they want to customize the request in a way that is not possible with the components, all right? So that would be actually probably the first thing that we will implement in this playlist. And we also need some kind of data processing. So we want to give people tools to basically parse images from Base64, convert microphone audio into a WAV file or an MP3 or a buffer that can be sent for, I don't know, all right? But we will implement some kind of data processing tools. And other design considerations, this was interesting discussion as well. Every component, because HTTP requests can take time, it is frustrating to have Grasshopper frozen for a few seconds while the requests happen. So if we want to chain a lot of requests, this could actually get quite frustrating. So I believe we're going to be using the Speckle async template quite a lot, so the components get triggered and then we get some kind of notification about how many seconds the component is taking to resolve. And then once it resolves, then the rest of the update chain keeps working. So we're going to do that. Maybe if we find that many components have the same similarities, they have similarities in terms of their requests, etc., maybe we create some kind of subclass that handles requests and then the components inherit from that class. That could be an interesting thing to learn because it taps into model inheritance, etc., etc. And it's also at the ground of how async components in Speckle, that template, how it works. All right, so it's actually quite similar. We would like to always offer for every component the raw response. So we will take the response and we will parse the response to extract what's interesting of each request. But we will also offer always the raw response in case the user, some more advanced user, wants to work with that response and deserialize it themselves, etc., etc. And then if the response has array data, so we will properly convert that into Grasshopper list of trees. All right, so that will be something that we will do manually. So I wrote here a roadmap of what could be the components that could be essential, and we were rating them 5, 4, etc., etc. So this is kind of like perhaps like a list of what to do first, what to do second, etc., etc. And then also for the sake of this recording, I wrote myself like what could be the videos that we could record for this playlist. And so right now we are doing overview of the goals. So I just crossed that out of the list, okay? And then the next thing that we will do in the next video will probably be to start the repo, put it on GitHub, clone the repo, create the new Visual Studio project, start from scratch, etc., etc. All right? Which I think it's probably what we want to do moving on. All right? So this file that I have here, the brain plugin notes, it is right now in my machine, but what I will do is that as soon as we start the repo, I will post that file there. So if you're watching this in the future, just make sure to go to the repository. I don't have a link for that yet. I need to do it on the next video. And then this document will be somewhere at the root of the project probably, and you can take a look at what we did, what we thought, and then, or maybe how all of this has evolved since me recording this video right now and between that and you watching this video in the future. All right, beautiful. So these were the goals. Again, you can check the live stream if you want to see how we actually consolidated and came to deciding all of this. You can also check how we did the literature review and we browsed through previous project. That was kind of interesting. And and I guess we are ready to start. So let's move on to the next video and start the project, create the repo, Visual Studio, etc., etc. All right. And in the meantime, as usual, if you liked or if this was useful, maybe you want to subscribe to the channel, like this video, say hi, join Discord, etc., etc. All of that. Thank you very much and see you in the next video. Let's get this project started. Bye.